Lauren Jenkins, hello.
Hi.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
You've just been on stage. How was that?
Really quick, but I think I had like 45 minutes and it felt like five. It was so fun.
Oh, wow. Okay. And what was the crowd like?
They were amazing. Yeah. I mean, first of all, it's a beautiful day here. I mean, the weather is stunning. And this is my kind of like my second tour in the EU, UK.
Great.
I was here back in March. And seeing people sing your songs never gets old, and meeting new people for the first time never gets old. So it was amazing.
Great. So do you have a favorite place in the UK that you've been to?
Here today. There's swans, there's lords and manors and sunshine.
Is it how like you visualize England being with like big stately homes like this?
No, because I think unless you've actually seen it in real life, you can't really imagine it.
Mm-hmm.
So pictures don't do it justice.
Yes.
You gotta come. Gotta come.
So when you're on the road and traveling, what are you listening to at the moment?
That's a great question. I listen to every genre of music. I'm a really big fan of Tyler Childers. He's
yes.
great. Maggie Rogers is also a big favorite yeah. for me, and always Led Zeppelin.
Oh my goodness. Okay, favorite Led Zeppelin track.
Ooh, it changes every day.
Yeah.
I think right now it's Thank You.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I like When the Levee Breaks the most, but then second and third place kind of change regularly.
Yeah. It depends on the day, the mood you're in.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Because they have something for every mood.
Mm-hmm.
We could talk about this for hours.
We could.
Let's
and
talk
for
about
the next
you.
2 hours, Led Zeppelin.
Do you have a ritual you like to do before you go on stage? Anything for luck?
Yeah. Well, I don't know about luck. I mean, just, you know, hold on tight. But I always try to dedicate the show to someone or something. So that usually involves whiskey.
Mm.
And then either whoever I'm playing the show with, or if management is with me, or if I'm just by myself, it's just in the reflection with some whiskey and dedicate the show to someone or something.
Amazing. Do you ever get nervous?
I used to. And not as much anymore. It's usually just excitement and kind of this feeling of appreciation and being mind blown of, oh my God, I get to play this show. And but no, I don't get super nervous anymore.
You just take it in your stride now. It's just
I think once you've done just hundreds and thousands of shows, the being nervous part kind of goes out the window, but the excitement nerves.
The adrenaline. Around.
Yeah.
Oh, it's addictive, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so I hear you've been directing music videos as well.
Yeah.
Ingrid's?
Yes.
How was that?
Yeah, so Ingrid, Andres, and I were really good friends, and we lived together for a while.
Wow.
And so we were roommates, and we've written together, and she wrote this song called The Stranger, and I was like, well, you need to do a music video for it, and I have this idea. So we had no budget, and I was like, well, I'll do it. And we were editing the video in coffee shops, and it was very DIY, which is most of my project too, and that's
yeah.
kind of my favorite projects, is when you do everything by yourself and mm-hmm. kind of are hands-on. So yeah, I love directing, and maybe I just love having control. I think that's the thing.
I get that. Yeah,
yeah.
Was she a good roomie?
Yeah, we lived together for about a year. We had both gotten out of some like weird living situations, and I was like, well, we should just live together. And we found this kind of sketchy house, and we lived in a basement of a house for like a year in Nashville. And
wow.
And then, you know, we both ended up moving because there were spiders and things in the house.
If you need a reason to get out,
yeah,
it's
spiders.
Yeah, absolutely. Jumping ahead a little bit, but Halloween. Are you a fan of Halloween?
Not hugely.
No?
No.
Because you go so big. Like, we're not as great at doing it in the UK. Like,
yeah,
we
it's
try.
A big thing.
Yeah.
It's a big thing in the States. There's a lot of Halloween parties, and I don't like spending money on costumes, so if I can't make it from some supplies in my kitchen or something, then it's not happening.
And have you seen anyone here? Have you been able to get front of stage?
No, not yet. We got in yesterday from Nashville. We flew into London and then drove 2.5 hours or something here and then immediately went to work. But for the next several hours, my only job is to enjoy the festival and get to see everybody. So
amazing.
I've seen my band and myself and you now.
Yes.
Yes, and which is all good things.
I recommend the pie and mash. I just had it.
Okay.
We're really proud of our pie and mash over here. Yes. So like if you want some food,
yeah,
it's just a suggestion for
this,
you.
This would be the place to have it.
Absolutely. Christmas, how do you spend Christmas?
It depends. I think it's interesting because holidays in general, for musicians and touring musicians, they sometimes don't exist. It's like, oh, is it a holiday? Everybody has a day off? Well, I'm in Illinois or something. Mm-hmm. So it depends. I try to see family if I can, but sometimes there's shows, and it's either Christmas or New Year's Eve. I'm playing with Muscadine Bloodline. So I don't know. Maybe I'm playing, which is a great, that's a great way to spend holidays, is with other people that enjoy music and getting to do the thing that you love.
So. Yeah, that's really nice.
Yes.
Yeah. What's your ultimate Christmas song?
Ultimate Christmas song? Probably one that I haven't written yet that will make me a bunch of money. That's my ultimate Christmas song.
Are you going for Christmas number one?
Yes.
We'll back you. We'll spin it.
Come on. I got to beat Mariah's. That's never going to happen. But, you know, goals.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for popping in. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Cheers.
Pie and mash. Next.
Today's Best Country.
Country Hits Radio.